Hi there. My name is Ruchi Chopra. I'm a lead product manager in the Microsoft Information Protection team. And this is part two of a series of videos on Microsoft Information Protection. This session will focus on our data loss prevention solution and specifically how it offers comprehensive coverage while at the same time balancing security with user productivity. I hardly need to belabor the fact that protecting sensitive data is a top priority for organizations today. And the problem is just exacerbated by the fact that we're all in this remote work situation these days. Employees are working from their own devices, non-corporate managed locations, and that has just raised the level of concern that organizations have around data leakage. Now, before I go too deep into our data loss prevention solution, let me just anchor this conversation in the larger context. So our Microsoft Information Protection solution has three core components. This slide is probably familiar to you if you've seen part one, where we covered know your data, which solves the dark data problem, the problem of identifying your sensitive data, determining where it lives and what users are doing with it. And then the second one is protect your data, which is about creating the right sets of policies to classify and label your sensitive data. And that then lends itself to the right sets of protections like encryption and watermarking. And then the third one, which is the focus of this session, is preventing data loss, which deals with preventing the loss of your sensitive data, inadvertent or otherwise, from your organization. Let's dig in a little more. So as I was saying in the beginning, a core focus for us is to have a comprehensive solution. And that's what you're seeing in that bubble on the left is we completely embrace the fact that for a solution to be effective, for data loss prevention to be effective, it needs to be comprehensive. Customers have told us that they want a single pane of glass. They want to use a single product that protects their data no matter where it lives. And that's exactly aligned with our strategy. So we have coverage for your data, whether it's living in Exchange, in emails, Teams, chats, documents on SharePoint or OneDrive, or even devices, endpoints. And it's not limited to the Microsoft ecosystem. Our coverage goes beyond. Through our Microsoft Cloud App Security solution, we extend our protection coverage to non-Microsoft clouds and apps as well. Now, all of this then comes together in a set of unified and integrated experiences, both for the admin and for the end user. And we're going to take a quick look at what that really means. Firstly, for the admin, you need to get started. You need to have the right set of information to know what kinds of policies to create. And that's where our guided onboarding comes in. Firstly, it's lightweight configuration, cloud native, no on-premises infrastructure to deploy and manage, no agents, just some lightweight configuration in the cloud and you're good to go. And before you've even created your first policy, you're going to start seeing insights come in about, like I was saying earlier, where your sensitive data lives, what kind of sensitive data is in the organization, and what kinds of activities are happening with that sensitive data. That can then inform the right sets of policies, protection policies to be created. And on to policy creation, we have a single place, the Microsoft 365 Compliance Center, where you will go to manage, to create, to monitor all your protection policies, regardless of what the location is where that data lives. It's also a very rich set of capabilities, a rich set of rules that you can, and conditions and exceptions that you can configure to really create the policies that are absolutely relevant for your context. Next, of course, as I said, our data loss prevention solution is a part of our overarching Microsoft Information Protection solution, and it leverages the same core platform of classification mechanisms, of labels. So for instance, we've got more than 100 built-in sensitive information types. We've got more than 40 templates that you can just use. An example is GDPR. You don't have to bother with figuring out what it means to identify GDPR data in your organization. We've done that heavy lifting for you, and you can just use it in your policies out of the box. Not just that, of course, you can customize all of these classifiers and really make them your own. And in addition, a lot of organizations, like I was saying, as part of the Protect Your Data pillar, choose to label their documents, their sensitive documents. Once you've labeled documents, those labels then lend themselves to being used in other policies, including data loss prevention policies. And now that you've got your policies in place, the next thing that's going to happen is alerts are going to start flowing in. And as those alerts flow in, no matter where the data lived, no matter where the alert was generated, it's all going to flow into one place where you can view the alerts. You're going to get the right level of detail to be able to triage those alerts, and then you're going to be able to remediate them. And that's not all. We don't limit you to our experience. For users who prefer to use SIMS or some other piece of software where they want to get alerts and where they want to do triage across multiple other sources, we offer rich API support as well. That is on par with what you will see in the experience. Switching over to the end user. For the end user, there is no plugin for the admin to deploy, to manage. The experiences are built into the apps that your users know and love. Office, Windows, Edge. Not just that, the admin has the knobs, the flexibility to determine where they want to rely more on user judgment and in what scenarios they want to enforce policy a little bit more strictly. That's how we draw that balance between security and productivity. And because all of these experiences are natively built in and understood by all of these applications, the experience is coherent across the board and looks and feels the same, leading to a more productive experience for your end users, easier for them to learn the experience and become aware of it. And of course, it's available across all of our platforms consistently. Now, don't take my word for all of this. Does the product really live up to its promise? We're going to take a look through a walkthrough. So here I am in the Microsoft 365 Compliance Center. This is the admin console where you're going to manage your data loss prevention policy, your information protection policy. The first thing you're going to do is click on data classification, which will tell you about where your sensitive data lives, what kind of sensitive data you have that you need to protect, and what are users doing with it. Once you have that, and we've covered that in more detail in part one, so I'm not going to go into much detail there, but I am going to show you quickly that you can dig in and actually see a preview of the sensitive files as well, if you have the right set of permissions. So in this case, continuing from the scenario we had in part one, there is a project called Project Obsidian, which is a top secret project for this organization, Contoso. And what the Contoso admin wants to do is create a data loss prevention policy so that Project Obsidian data cannot be shared externally. The first thing, of course, they're going to do is look at all the Project Obsidian data in their organization. So that's what they're doing here. And then they're going to go into data loss prevention and start to create policies to protect that data. So when they click on create a policy, they're going to choose custom policy because it's the set of conditions that they're going to have is custom to this organization. It's about Project Obsidian. They're going to give it a name. They choose to give it the same name, Project Obsidian, give it a description. Now here's where you're seeing all the locations that the admin can deploy this policy to. And you see the breadth of it. In one place, you can configure policy for Exchange, SharePoint, OneDrive, Teams, devices, and Microsoft Cloud App Security. So let's just dig into Microsoft Cloud App Security, and you can see the specific applications, and they can choose which applications they want to apply that policy to. And once they've done that, they're going to define the specific settings for each of those locations. And they're going to say, I do not want this data to go to be shared with users outside my organization. And the condition that they're going to apply is that any file that has the Project Obsidian label on it is under the purview of this policy. So now what are the actions that they want to apply? One, they can configure email notifications that are sent to the users, or in-app policy tips that I was talking about, that each of these apps actually will natively support data loss prevention policy. And they can configure, really go into detail around, you know, what thresholds they want to have before alerts are generated. Not just that, they can customize the content of those policy tips or the alerts that are sent to the user. They can also allow the decide whether they want to allow the user to override the policy or not. Again, going back to balancing security and productivity. Now we're going to look at some device or location specific policy conditions. What you're seeing here on the top is for Windows devices, they have all of this flexibility to protect whether that data or Project Obsidian data is being uploaded to a cloud service that's not supported or not allowed. Copy to clipboard, copy to USB or removable media, copy to a network share, access by unallowed apps, printing. And for each of these, there's the flexibility to say, I just want to audit. I just want to know whether the user did that, or I actually want to block, or I want to block but allow the override. So that was on devices. Then we were also seeing that this policy applies to third-party apps. For each of the apps that are under the purview of this policy, the admin can configure exactly what level of controls they want to have for Project Obsidian data. At the end, they can choose to test the policy before they actually deploy it. And then they'll review it, make sure that it looks good, and then go ahead and deploy. And now once it's deployed, let's take a look at the experience for the end user. So here you are seeing Teams, again, natively understanding the policy and allowing the user to override. You're seeing in Word, the user attempted to copy some content that was relevant to Project Obsidian. This document is a Project Obsidian document, and you can see that Word blocked that action along with an explanation, which was all configured by the admin. Here you can see in File Explorer that the user was attempting to do a copy, but that was again blocked by Windows. Here you're seeing an attempt to copy into Dropbox, which was again blocked by Edge. And all of this is native. So to summarize, the quantity of sensitive data that you need to manage is only exploding. That problem is further getting exacerbated by our current remote work situation. But there are several options that Microsoft Information Protection offers to help you protect that data. You can label that data, and you can define data loss prevention policies that will protect that data no matter where it lives, whether it's in the cloud, within Microsoft locations or non-Microsoft locations, and on users' devices. And it'll do all of that while offering built-in and integrated experiences to your end users. There's a number of useful links here, a number of resources for you to learn more about this topic. Feel free to pause here. And lastly, the team would love to engage with you, so do find us on Yammer. Thank you.